I'm Sir Tabtalk, and welcome to Let's Play Slime Rancher, a few copies games provided by the developer. This is a farming simulation game focusing on slimes, as you might guess. The beginning of the game is a little slow. The general pace of the game is fairly slow. I played about 3-4 hours in a row today, to be quite honest. And it's a very fun, relaxing game. I am doing a 5-day challenge currently. I went and waited until I got on day 2 so I could actually show some of the more interesting stuff. The first day of the game is pretty boring regardless of what you do. So it's a little annoying to have to redo that boring bit every time the 5-day challenge, but hey, that's why I skipped it for you. So the basis of the game is you can grab these little slimes, catch them in your pens here, and feed them, and they drop these plorts, which are little gems that you can sell. So to start off the game, you can go out here into the wilderness, grab some slimes. These are the pink slimes. They are almost worthless. They're not quite. But what I do is leave them out in the wilderness, and I collect the plorts they drop so I can sell those. You can't sell the slimes themselves, but you can sell the stuff they drop. So a big goal here is there's actually we just passed it. There's these big slimes that you can feed their favorite food, and they will eventually pop, and they give you more access to the map. It's sort of like unlocking regions in Harvest Moon, like when you unlock the mines and stuff. So large sections of the map will open up once you can actually fill them. I don't have enough food right now, so I'm just sort of looking for... Oh! Actually, those chickens won't do. But while we're out here, we may as well collect a bunch of stuff. I have a chicken coop back home, so I can collect all these chickens and grow them for food. I generally don't like to depend on chickens. Those are your main source of meat, because they're a little less replenishable than, carrots. Vegetables are the way I prefer to grow things. Carrot chicken. But chickens do well with these cat-shaped slimes. There's a bunch of different types of slimes. Here we see a rock slime, a phosphor slime, a cat slime, and a pink slime. There's sort of an ascending order of how much the plorts they drop are worth. The phosphor slimes and the cat slimes are what I'm currently focusing on. They are the best payouts that I can currently get. But they're not as easy to handle as the pink slime. The pink slimes are very easy to handle, but their earning rate is just crap. So that's why I immediately went to higher stuff. That big fat slime there is my major impediment of progress, and unfortunately, until some more food grows... Oh, here we go. I'm not sure I can get past it. Well, let's see what's grown on the farm, deposit these hens, and then we'll try and get past Mr. Big Pink Slime. Here's my little coop. I honestly felt like I wasted the coop, but as long as you don't spend too much money on a coop, it's good food for my cat slimes. I do have a bunch of cat slimes. So once the slimes are in the pen, you can grab these little plorts they make. They only make plorts after feeding them. Excuse you. As you can see, it's a little difficult to harvest them. We can, with enough money, we can buy an auto harvester. It will make our job a lot easier. That's a fairly big expense at the moment. I might be able to afford one of them after I get all of these plorts. So these nets keep in the slimes, but the player character can go through them. They can also jump out of the top, depending on what kind of slimes they are. The cat slimes are very good at getting out, excuse you. So you have to do these double tall pens. But my pens should be pretty safe. There's sort of a stock market thing where prices go up and down for the plorts, but, you know, the gems they drop. But I think in 5-day challenge mode, those are static. It would make sense. There's a normal, like, endless game mode, which I'm at pretty much the current end game. Like I said, it's an early access game, so it's definitely missing some content. It's missing a whole region, at least, and some slime types and food types. I'll show you my ranch after we finish our little 5-day challenge here. We're almost halfway through already, because I skipped the first day or so. Oh, come on, grow food. Well, that's frustrating. Well, we have some money to spare, even though we don't have much food to spare, so we are going to get... Actually, let's go ahead and get Plort Collector. The food dispenser, I find, isn't really very valuable. And the music box just keeps them less agitated, which certain slimes, these guys, obviously, are aggressive. Certain slimes aren't aggressive, so you don't really need the music box isn't really all that essential. The most aggressive slimes are the explosive slimes, which I'm not sure we'll even get to see in a 5-day thing. I hope, hopefully so, but explosive slimes suck, basically. They fly out of the cage no matter what you do to keep them in. They're just really frustrating to work with, and they don't really have an appropriate payout to justify all of the pain they bring. So, I don't mean, like, actual damage to you. They are just so frustrating to work with, and they knock their gems out of the pen, and they just cause all kinds of troubles. And they're not, you know, they pay off well, but not well enough. Oh! I was a single fruit. Are you kidding? I was a single fruit. Sometimes you'll see these boxes. These have rare items. Well, not rare, but uncommon foods and stuff. We just got some chickens, and the pink slimes ate the chickens. The pink slimes are omnivorous. They will eat basically anything that is considered food. Actually, they will eat absolutely everything that is considered food. Excuse me. Oh, rest in peace. So now we have a key. We have two ways we can go. I think we will go and get the rad slimes. You get stuck on weird geometry in this game. Like I said, early access and all that. But the game doesn't have good decision making when you're stuck in geometry. It lets you escape eventually, so I mean it could be worse, but sometimes you just get a little wedged in there. So the phosphor slimes only appear at night, and they're a really great source of money early on, but you have to buy a special pen for them. So what I do is first I get the rock slimes and the cat slimes, and then I grow those together, like here, and then once I get, I think I need about $1,500, I can build a pen that has a double wide or double tall enclosure, and also has the sunproofing, which is essential for the phosphor ones. I'm not exactly sure what happens without the phosphor, or with the solar protector is what it's called, or something like that. They don't, like, instantly disappear or anything, but it does say they need them. I didn't really want to see what happened when they... Come on, there you go. I'm not really sure when that Plort Collector thing actually kicks in. It seems to let them pile up for a little while before actually building them up. So that slime key we got from the big guy, that unlocks a new region, and there's actually, I believe, 3 keys, and you can kind of choose which ones you go to. I think I'm gonna go for this nearest one here. My two favorite slimes are, well, the puddle slimes are really good, but not all of the slimes combine. Puddle slimes, which we haven't actually seen yet, don't combine, but they have really good payout and they're really low maintenance, which is strange because their encyclopedia entry says they're very high maintenance, But all you actually have to do is have a pond, and they don't require food, and they don't intermix with other slimes. So they're actually very simple, so I'm not really sure what the encyclopedia entry is going on about. Oh, speaking of, we can take a look at the Slimopedia here. You can see what kind of slimes we've got. It's like the cat slime here eats meat, and its favorite food is stony hen. Rock slimes of heartbeat. When you give them the favorite food, I believe they drop two of each kind of plort. And so that's pretty useful, but not essential. I don't really care about the favorite food at the moment. So now we've unlocked this new area, the Indigo Quarry. We should be seeing some new slime types pretty soon. Oh, we can see explosive slimes. I actually don't want to hang out with the explosive slimes. As you see, the slimes sort of fuse as they wander about here. What's happening is if a slime touches a plort from a different type of slime, they will charge up into a larger slime. I forget what exactly it's called. Oh, it's a Larjo, right? Yes. Pink Rock Larjo, so that's a... Wait, Phosphor Rock Larjo. That's a Phosphor one crossed with a Rock one. We have not actually seen the new slime type that I want. We could get the explosive ones. Explosive ones eat meat. Needing meat is a higher maintenance sort of slime. And, to boot, the explosive ones damage you when you're near them, and they have a tendency to fly out of the containment pen, and they're just a real pain. I do not like them at all. Oh, good. Oh, never mind. It's dead. I noticed this when I came in here the first time. There's a special type of food that we can get here, but it's all dead when we first get in here. Heartbeat is actually not what we want, but it'll be okay. Don't need that pogo fruit. You can only carry four different types of items. You can upgrade how many of each item you can carry. Here we go. These guys are valuable. And actually, don't need that rock slime. Sorry. You can also upgrade your gun to be able to inhale water and shoot it out. Oh, heartbeat. I'll take that. Is there only two puddle slimes? Crap. This area usually has three to four. Puddle slimes are very valuable. Oop! I can't believe I did that. Well. Fortunately, we wasted almost no time, but that's still pretty bad. Let's feed all of these to our cats. We did lose the puddle slimes, and I'm not sure those will have respawned by the time I get back there, unfortunately. So that's kind of bad. They will not keep producing plorts if you don't feed them, so the plorts in here are just from last night's feeding. Hey, I'm really not sure when that thing triggers. It seems to have not triggered very often, and then, like, I'll come here to get them, and then it decides to trigger. Out of space. Should probably just buy that space upgrade. So there's lots of upgrades we can get here. So we can upgrade the size of our tank, how much the power meter is just for running, and for our jetpack, which we don't have. The jetpack may have saved us back there, but didn't have it yet. I'm not sure I wanna... Since this is the 5-day challenge, you basically just want to make as much money as you can within 5 days. That's fairly restrictive. My main save file is at 20 days now. But, jetpack is pretty good to avoid falls like the one we just experienced back there. One important farm management tip, if a Largo, you know, one of these double-type larger slimes, touches the plort of a third type of slime, they turn into an evil slime, and you have to get rid of it or kill it, or it'll kill all of your slimes, and it's very unpleasant. You'll probably do that on accident your first time trying to build up a little ranch. It's not really a big deal, But it's a mistake you only make once you realize what you did wrong. And the Slimepedia is very useful for telling you, you know, what you need to do and what you've done wrong. So, like, have I even seen bad slimes yet in this? No, I have not seen bad slimes in this playthrough yet. They do spawn naturally in certain areas with multiple slimes that intermix. So, we'll probably see them, not due to my own incompetence, but due to just environmental factors. Alright, so let's get back here. I feel a little weird not having all of my upgrades. Once you've played for a while, you'll have basically three times the amount of running length, and you'll have a pretty good jetpack. They can get you, you don't get too high vertically, but it'll let you travel pretty decent distances horizontally without falling. Not sure what those guys are congregating for. So yeah, rock slimes are cute, but we don't really want to worry about those too much. What we really want right now are the rad slimes, which are further in this area. Rad slimes are nice because they are, well, they're rad. But they give really good money, and they aren't really very hard to take care of. Unlike certain exploding slimes, which I am not even gonna bother with. They just make me mad. For some reason, I kept a whole pen full of explosive slimes for far too long before I realized, hey, this is just absolutely not worth it. I think if you keep less of them in a pen, it may be less of a problem. But why would you do that when you can keep more of a higher value slime that doesn't, you know, blow up your ranch, literally? The rock slimes are very good early on. They're a little aggressive, but they're pretty easy to handle, really. You shouldn't be worried about them. Arrgh. I'm looking for the fruit, or the vegetable that grows only in this area. But for some reason, when you first enter the area, none of it has spawned. It's frustrating. Ah, come on. So none of those puddle slimes respawned, as I feared. I can't believe I fell off this bridge. I've fallen off a couple times. Okay, I did get the jetpack right. Recharge. Okay, this is gonna be risky. Okay, recharge. Okay. These green ones are rad slimes. Rad slimes are very rad. They have nice high payout, and they are radioactive, as you might guess from the name and the green glow, but they're actually not very dangerous. Get out of here, pink slimes. Okay, those are feral slimes. They are actually very dangerous with my low health. I just wanted some fruits. Or some veggies, rather. Red slimes eat veggies, so we want the veggies in this area because they're their favorite food, and we can grow more of them. But I'm gonna guess they're all eaten up, because they always are. There's a few things about this game that definitely feel a little early access. It's very, very fun, visually very polished. The controller support is fantastic. Yes! Okay, okay. No, give me. Oh, no! Oh, for Pete's sake. The item situation is a little frustrating sometimes. Since you only get four things, if you pick up the wrong item, it will prevent you from picking up the thing that you wanted to get. And that is just not very fun. So that's what happened just now. I dropped the heartbeat to collect the other type of vegetable, picked the heartbeat right back up, and fortunately we get to grab some here. Oka Oka is what we want to grow the rad slimes. We don't have many rad slimes, but that's alright. We'll stretch out the rad slimes numbers with probably some cat slimes. When you're making a hybrid, what you really want to think about is how easy the resulting slime will be to feed. So, like, if you combine two slimes that require meat, The combined slime will also require meat, and meat's kind of hard to get. If you combine something that eats meat and something that eats vegetables, you can feed that vegetables or meat, and that just makes it a lot easier to deal with. That's the exit. Okay. So generally, I like to make sure things can eat fruit and vegetables, or fruit and meat. Meat and vegetables is kind of lame, but it works. Vegetables are just a little harder to get a hold of, because of these Oka Okas, mostly. They're just in the more limited area, and things tend to eat them very quickly. It's kind of annoying. I'm really surprised we got two Oka Okas. It took me 3 attempts to get a single Oka Oka my first game. So like I said, my main save file is actually basically at endgame. That took me about 4 or 5 hours, like, played pretty much straight, to be quite honest. I don't really want to tear down these, but I do need some more fruits. New garden. Sprinkler. Sprinkler doubles the speed at which things grow. So, alright, I need a new pen too. Rad slimes are actually very not dangerous to be around. They just increase this rad meter. Parker, don't!
Don't claw me!
Yeah, they just require vegetables, and you just can't, like, sit in the middle of a horde of them. And otherwise, you're gonna be pretty much perfectly fine. Let me consider what I want to breed the rad slimes with. Rad slimes are that green one there, very expensive. Ideally, I want to breed the rad slimes with honey slimes, but I can't get honey slimes right now. Honey slimes require another key, which I'm not sure we're even going to get. I don't remember where the second big slime to even... Oh wait, no, I know a way. I would have to get a lot of money though. So these slimes' favorite food is the cube berries. So I'm just gonna feed them a bunch of those. I think these guys are left over pogo fruits. And the game has fairly good persistence for whatever's at the ranch, so you can just overfeed them. And the food, I think food does eventually go bad, but it takes a while. At least I find food gone spoiled in the wild. I don't really tend to see it spoiled in the farm. Alright, what did I decide on here? Oh, phosphor and cats are both fine. I think I might crossbreed them with cats then. You will need an actual slime to get more large slimes, but you only need one type, as long as you have the plorts of the other type. So like, if I brought cat things in here, I could use these gems to make the large cat rad plorts. I could make rad cat slimes, even though I only have the cats, as long as I have the blort crystals. So actually I'm just gonna leave these here. Phosphor plorts, let's sell all these. Phosphor is actually just fine too. Phosphor ones are easier to get. And since I have limited time, I may actually opt for that first. Oh man! A lot of these. Alright. Very cute cartoony sound effects for the slimes. So this game's super relaxing. It has a somewhat limited amount of content. You can continue playing just to watch your ranch, you know, ranch out your dudes, but there is a limited amount of space in your ranch, and that's a little frustrating. Oh wait. These guys can't eat fruit. So Well, I wasted all of this fruit. I'm not used to dealing with this particular type of slime, actually. I usually go straight for things that eat fruit, because fruit is pretty much the easiest thing to get. Okay, now I need lots of phosphorus slimes. I'm rushing because of the 5-day limit thing. There is absolutely no need to rush in the normal game. You can get knocked out as many times as you want. There's nothing... You lose your current inventory, so you kind of don't want to get knocked out, but it doesn't actually end your game or anything. So, you can play the game very chill. You really don't want to do the 5-day challenge first. I'm just doing this to show it off at a more frantic pace, and also because I don't really want to start a new slow save file. And my main save file is already completed, so I thought this was a good in-between. So now we have some phosphor slimes. We should have enough money to build up a pen. So I can expose these phosphor slimes to these rad crystals to make phosphor rad slimes. And those will drop two different types of plorts, one for each base type. Like I said earlier, you can't combine three different types of blorts. That makes an evil... Why do I keep calling them blorts? You cannot combine three different types of slime, because that makes an evil slime that will just try to murder all your other slimes. That's not very fun. So now we have those guys growing. Do these heavies? Yes, good. So since these are the favorite food of the rad slimes, another nice thing about combining slimes is that either favorite food of the base varieties will work as a favorite food. So I can feed these guys just Oka-Okas, and they'll consider it a favorite food and produce more thingies, more plorts. Let's just make a plort collector because I'm lazy. And is this about done? No, it's not. It's kind of frustrating. I want to grow more stuff. You can also expand your ranch. It's about 2,000 gold. Yeah, you can expand it in two different ways. One is a cave where you can grow phosphor guys without having to build a sunscreen. So it's slightly cheaper on the whole if you make a bunch of phosphor ones there. Phosphor ones really aren't the best in general. It sucks that it actually costs money to demolish a thing, so I'm not gonna do that quite yet. So due to the wheels of progress, these guys are actually basically worthless to me right now, especially since I have so many fruits and so little, and the veggies I really want to give to the rat slimes anyway. Ah, great. I wondered if I had to create a ceiling for these guys' pen. I guess I do. As you can see, even grabbing onto them isn't very dangerous. You just can't do it for too long. And you should never need to grab onto them for that long unless you're really bad, frankly. But, just feed them those. Carrying them inside the gun, the little plort gun, is not painful, fortunately. Despite the home icon appearing, you never need to sleep. I think it's just telling you you have a new upgrade thing you can buy. I don't really need any of these, though. So are you all grown? Yes. Let's make this a fruit patch. And all you need is one fruit to grow a thing. I have a couple complaints with how the building system works. I feel a little restricted. Ugh. How did you get out? You get back in there. And you get back in there. If I had a ceiling, actually, I think I'm just gonna make a ceiling. This is... Well... Yeah, I need a ceiling. It kind of sucks to have to build a ceiling. If I were, you know, to min-max, you probably wouldn't want to build a ceiling quite yet. But It's a little frustrating, and I don't want to spend the entire video corralling those idiots. Have you got some? Yes. Oh crap, what was I talking about? Okay, but there's a couple of building types that feel very useless. The silo, I never really found that much of a need to store that many extra things, so I never found the silo very useful. Beyond the silo, what else was there? There's a pond which you can build for the puddle slimes, but you have so few spaces, it feels kind of weird to dedicate space to a silo or the chicken coop, because I find the I find either fruits or veggies to be way more effective than the growing chickens, because chickens, it's a fairly low return for a pretty, you gotta grow a lot of chickens to get a decent amount of food for the little dudes. And food, meat doesn't bring more plorts unless it's the favorite food. So it's just really not too worth it. One complaint about controls, this game does unfortunately have the stick click in to run thing. It helps if you have a controller that you can just use a back paddle for, like the Steam controller or the Xbox One Elite controller. Not required, obviously, but it's nice to have if you have one of those controllers. Just press the little back button, zip right along. Ugh. Oh wait, are you slow? No, you're not. There's also this little trader. I never find it too useful. It's actually a very easy trade, though. I need more cube fruits, though. You unfortunately, like, need to jetpack to get the one that grows on the top. It's really annoying. There you go, for Pete's sake. Oh, come on. See, I'm not even sure if I'm gonna get that rather easy trade thing just because I don't happen to have exactly what it needs. The trade things cycle every day. Let's see what I would get for that trade. Ooh! That's like $1,000 right there, I think. Oh, I have a ton of uneaten blueberries. So let's do that trade right now. Gold slimes are different. You can't grow gold slime. They just have a rare chance of spawning and will give you a large amount of money. And, but you have to bring the... They don't give you money directly. They give you those gold plorts. Oh, dang. You can get auto feeders for these. The auto feeders are pretty hard to keep filled. Generally farming, it's hard to keep up. It's hard to keep a farm that keeps up with your little dudes. But they don't starve to death or anything, but if you don't feed them, they're not gonna grow plorts. So, let's feed the fruit to those. I actually need to give those red plorts back in so we grow some more, I think. Yeah, there you go. Nuclear radiation. Isn't it beautiful? It's kind of funny that the rad plorts are one of the safest things to have. Like, one of the safest ones to give really good amounts of money. Those explosive ones really suck. I'm not exactly sure when this mission mode ends. If it's like the moment we hit the fifth day or the end of the fifth day. But I guess we'll just keep going at this point. Yeah, it's cheap enough, we can get that. We definitely want more energy. Water tank. Don't really need the water tank, actually. The water tank lets you combat the evil slimes, and that's pretty much it, really. It's not very necessary. You can If the evil slimes are on your ranch, that's really bad, and you want the water gun, but that should never happen unless you're very inexperienced and you accidentally let it happen. Let's see, I don't really need the auto feeder because I can just overfeed them and they'll just eat it as they need to. Alright. Where is... Oh! I'm gonna go scout for some water plorts. Or I keep calling them plorts. They're not plorts. They're slimes. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get some puddle slimes. I guess I'm saying puddle plorts because it rolls off the tongue so nicely. Not sure why we're getting frame rate issues here. I can't run this game quite at full graphic settings on my old 6950, but I can get a solid 60 pretty much all the times when I'm not recording. On medium with slime detail and a couple other settings set to high. Yeah, I'm not sure what is up with that. Let me just drag down the settings back to default. See if that improves. Yeah, it's a little better. Oh, there it is! That's the evil slime thing. So yeah, anytime there's a bunch of, there's three different slime types, those guys can spawn. And if you don't stop it, it'll eventually kill all of the slimes. We can feed that slime a bunch of carrots. It'll just lead to a teleport. I think it's just back to our ranch. It's not a very useful one. Like, it's a nice shortcut to have in the main game mode. It's absolutely not worth it in this particular game mode. There's only two game modes so far. There's the 5-day challenge, and then there's this regular no-timer, do-what-you-want, regular Harvest Moony mode. Please have some pawn things. Oh, you're- oh, okay. Just one? You're kidding. Just one. No way. I wonder if those have a decreased spawn rate in this mode or something. I always find two or even three. Let's grab those rad slimes. I'm sure this is like nowhere near speedrun status. I'm sure there's some good ways to get a lot of money and get the slime types that I'm currently missing. Oh god, charge the frickin' thing! This is actually my first run in 5-day challenge mode. Aw, it already evolved. The large ones you can move with the gun, but you can't suck them up into an item slot, so you pretty much have to leave them in the wild. Unless you want to carry them all the way back. And several of them would actually kill you before you got all the way back. Any of the ones that fight back. So, generally not a good idea. Excuse me. Thank you. Well, this excursion was kind of a bust. But I kind of needed to wait for my stuff to grow on the farm anyway. There's a nice shortcut you can use with a high-powered jetpack to get... It's not a big shortcut, but you can go to the other side of that loop that I just went through if you have a good enough jetpack. Wait, I have to go up this ridge. I got a little lost in here the first time I came in this area. So there's, I think, two major areas that we're not really seeing much of in this episode because I can't really show them. I'll do a second video where I show off my, like, modern day ranch. I think this just became a home and garden show. But where I show off my ranch as it is after, like, 20 days of whatever. The normal gameplay mode. Do I have... No, I can't carry those. Arg. The puddle slime are good, but if I only get one... It's not very worth it. So I'm in a bit of a conundrum here. I can... If I open that up... no, I wouldn't have access to the puddle thing if I opened that. Well, this sucks. I'm not sure what to do with my puddle slime. The puddle slime require a pond, unlike the other ones. So, but they're very low maintenance, high cost or high price little dudes. But I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to actually use them. That is dangerous. They won't generally touch plorts outside of their pen. I still don't like seeing that plort just on the ground like that. I'm trying to think of where else you can get the puddle plorts, puddle slimes. This is not plort ranger, this is slime ranger. I'm blanking on. Oh, no, I know. That requires another key, and another key would be pretty hard to get right now. Let's just sell everything. Oh, hey, whoa. Don't go spilling crap everywhere. Okay, this is really annoying. They're really close to causing a evil slime, so just put a cap on their hit. I'm honestly not really sure this game lends itself well to a 5-day challenge mode. It's... you kind of are missing out on a lot of the fun gameplay stuff in the first few days, and you don't really have enough time to build up almost any of it. I do like the idea, and, you know, makes a more focused burst of gameplay, but I definitely prefer the main game mode. There's not too much replayability, because once you've done it, you've done it. I'm sorry, Mr. Puddle Slime, but I need more space. You can get that. The 4-item limit is a little restrictive. So, what I'm gonna do next is buy. Oh wait, you're still alive. I think I may be able to keep that alive after I sell all this. I figured it would die almost instantly. Maybe I can preserve it though. Come here, little friend. The encyclopedia thing implied they would die almost instantly. Let's see what a good status for, as you can see, I've gotten most of the achievements already, but there's some achievements that are only in the 5-day challenge thing. They're way at the bottom. I think I can definitely do that 10,000 new bucks. That 5,000 new bucks does not seem 50,000. That's... I don't see that happening, but, we'll see. Especially not first time, probably not a very sane goal. Unfortunately, to get another key, I'm gonna need meat. So let's open up this area. The group. Unfortunately, this has some new plots. There's only 3 areas where we can have plots. So let's just plop down a little pond. Ponds are nice because they're pretty cheap, and they require no form of maintenance whatsoever. There we go. We actually need a ton of hens for this next slime key to open up another area. Fortunately, as long as I remember to open the right one, we should be able to immediately go into the area to get our honey slimes. Once I get the honey slimes, I'm gonna have to just be hardcore farming. Where'd you go? That 20's pretty good. I don't think this will be enough, though. The slimes are pretty hungry. So over here, there's a cat big slime. Wait, aren't you gonna spawn chickens? I guess I was teetering right on the level of proper performance before recording. That or something weird's going on, because I didn't really think I would be starting to get frame drops once I started recording. Alright, we don't have enough. The jetpack is pretty weak, but it's good enough, I guess. Chickens. Also, you can rescue the little chicks. The slimes will never eat the little chicks, so you can bring those back to your ranch and grow them into full-size chickens. So you can brutally slaughter them later. Which is obviously the humane thing to do. We do not want to waste a slime key on that stupid door. That stupid door is just a shortcut. I don't think it has anything interesting behind it at all. I thought this game was a lot... Well, not a lot, but I thought this game was shorter than it actually is. Because I opened that door second. And it turns out that it's a terrible idea. Chicken. Fortunately, the stony hens are the cat slime's favorite. I still don't think we're gonna have enough here. Also, the slimes do cute little slime powers. Uh-oh. You gotta wait for your jetpack. And they do this to sort of try and escape from their pens sometimes, but only the small ones do that. So I just try to evolve them as quickly as possible. Oh, come on. Yeah, so we're just barely gonna be able to get that thing. I wonder if any more have spawned back home. I'd be so mad if it turns out this last chicken was all it would have taken, but I don't think so. Because it took a lot of work, my first playthrough. Okay, good, they all respawn. Okay, this might be enough then. If you would get in the gun... Chicken! Thank you. Is that all of them? I was hoping for an even 10. But that number isn't really based on anything. You didn't even make a plort yet. Unfortunately, you can only put four pawn slimes in one thing. So they're not the most useful things ever. Like, they'll earn less than a full group of other slimes, but as far as how little effort is involved, they're very nice little slimes. Please be enough, please be enough, please be enough. Oh, come on, man! So, if we are lucky, we will see the fifth type of slime, or the, not the fifth. Where did I get fifth? We'll see the honey slime, which is actually my most used slime in the main game. It's partly because I didn't find rat slimes until the end, but the honey slimes are very good. They have no oddities, then they eat fruit, so they're very easy to deal with. They actually can't hit you at all, either, unless you pair them with something that's dangerous. So they're even less dangerous than rad slimes, but rad slimes aren't really as dangerous as they sound anyway. And if you remember earlier, we can unlock that area there for another 2,000 and get some more areas to grow phosphor slimes without having to have a sun visor, but we don't really need to waste that money in the challenge mode. Ah. Unfortunately, the farms don't really work half as well until you upgrade them. So I'm gonna have to run around looking for chickens, I guess. I gotta have at least 10,000. That is my bare minimum. I want that. Is it 25,000? That might be a possibility. I think if I stopped doing anything, 10,000 would be very easy, so. Okay, that's not gonna grow in time, so let's just remove it. And plant some more okra. Arg. Can I grab everything? Alright, so just in case these grew, I don't think they grow that fast. Oh, they do! Come here. Don't tell me it's just one. Where is it? You useless plort! Okay, there we go. I knew I heard chickens, and I was like, where the heck? They hide really well on that grass. Alright. Please be enough. I haven't done way too many trips. Don't eat the chickens, I need those. Okay, please, please, please be enough. I hate you so much, cat slime. All right, where's the other hens? You ate them, didn't you? Stop eating them! Oh, for Pete's sake. I can still hear them, but I don't... Yeah, I think they're all dead. Oh, that's what you get for eating my chickens. Now you're all gonna die. I hope you're happy. I sure as heck am. Bleh. I'm not saving you. Oh, wait. Please be the one. I'm gonna call you Neo. Neo, please. Damn it. He was not the one. Too old for the training. Alright. Crap. Honestly, at this point, it's kind of been a waste of time to go for that stupid second slime key. But I'm really close. Infuriatingly close. You finally made a single plort. You were barely worth bringing back, you stupid water thing. I guess you need all four to really get a decent plort right out of those guys. Nothing. You jerks need to grow faster. Yeah, it's not even worth a ton, the individual ones. Maybe 10,000 is about as good as we'll do. Not what I was hoping for, but we still get a Chivo, right? That's the only thing that matters. Yeah. I'm not sure how long they take to get hungry again, but they won't eat just infinite crap that you give them. They have to recharge or whatever. Get hungry again. Oh, I'm full. That was stupid. I think I mentioned earlier, but the game plays really well with the gamepad. You'd never need precise aiming. All the mappings are very reasonable. The game works fine with keyboard and mouse, too. Neither really has any advantage, in my opinion. So just play whatever you're comfortable with. Honestly, at this point, I should just be farming phosphor plorts and making a bunch of more ranch things. Come here, you suckers. That is fortunate. They do not usually spawn in that big of a horde. Dang. Nice. Okay. Got any more for me? I shouldn't have used up all my rad crystals. This thing. The corral. Claws. Solar shield. Air net. Heart collector. Very stupid roosters. You're all gonna die for forsaking me. Oh, come on, don't leave the pen. Crap, now what do I need? Right. Press the fruit I can feed to these jerks. This. All in all, the game's just really nice and relaxing. It's not super deep or anything, but I just really enjoyed playing it pretty much all day. Time to irradiate you. How did you get out? Get back in there. For some reason, the smaller ones actually are way better at getting out than the bigger ones, because they jump higher. They still reach the top, but with that net, they tend to stay in there. The explosive ones, though, whew boy, those get out all the time, and I hate them. Chicken, your time has come. You're gonna die. Where's that rooster? Kill that rooster too. Brewster. Where are you? There it is. It's time to meet your fate. Alright, so if these respawned, then I should be good. They, of course, did not respawn. Crap. What's it do? Oh! Some of them did. Maybe all of them, they just didn't spawn the place I expected. Okay, please give me the key. I'm basically showing you the third area for your benefit at this point, because I actually think it would be more worthwhile, money-wise, to just make as many pens as I can and farm the rad slimes. Are you kidding me? You jerk! This is what happens to your followers for your crimes against me. No, don't eat the pet. No! I must save the chickens so I can eat them. I am the noblest chicken saver. Come here. Is that all of them? I don't know why this one is so frustrating. The one that you feed vegetables is not nearly this fussy. Which is funny, because vegetables are way easier to get, too. It's the Sony hens are its favorite, so I think they count as two. So there's a slight chance this might go okay. Kinda nice sunrise. I can't believe I missed. Oh, for... Why did I even try? I guess you just gotta go immediately for either rad slimes or honey slimes and just ignore all pretense of getting the second key. Because holy crap, that is just rude. How many chickens have I fed it now? Like, 40? I'm not even gonna bother feeding it too. Ugh. Well, you'll see the honey slimes in my other video where I show you my main farm. Would you inhale them, please? You're not even trying to suck in the things. For now on, I guess it's just plain old farming. So, I guess I'll just time warp and see if I'll see if I can unlock that stupid thing. It's probably not worth it. This is our last day. Would you inhale the things? For Pete's sake. There you go. Are those all fully grown? I think so, yeah. I guess I'll just time warp at this point, because now I just kind of need to manage my farm and not waste my time on that stupid chicken thing. I can't believe how many... that's just so frustrating. So much time wasted on that stupid slime. Well, I got painfully close to 25,000. But, not close enough. My big mistake was obviously going for that stupid second slime key with the big, you know, feeding that slime. That was just not gonna happen. I figured it would have ended at 6 o'clock on the 6th day. Maybe I have until noon? I'm not sure. I guess it depends on when the first day started, maybe? All I really need is a bunch more rad gems, if I could get a bunch of veggies, I guess. I was hoping... Ah, damn it. Okay, that's not gonna help. Oh, hey! Come here. Ah, I think you have to hit that guy with stuff instead of trying to inhale him. That's the lucky cat thing. I think they give you money if you hit them, I guess? Please eat the carrots. Oh, good. Oh man, this is gonna be a nail biter. Nowhere near the 50 thou, but I can get the 25. What are these just doing up? Oh. Get back in here. Yeah, that's right, Parker. He was out of his cage. How dare he? I know. Yeah. You tell him, Parker. Please have a ton of- Oh no! Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Please don't end at 8, please don't end at 8. Please go to noon. Please go to noon, please go to noon, please go to noon. No, 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 no. Is this- Is my 5-day challenge not over? I'm confused. I have no idea when this ends. I thought it would end at 6. Actually, I thought it would end at midnight, but... No, we're still not at the end, I guess. So... Feed these guys. I think I can do the 25,000 then. Wait, that is the achievement, right? Ugh, I hate that. Okay, that's much faster. Okay, 25,000, yeah. Okay. Did you guys fill the flirt receptacles already? Hey! You can just sit on a pile of crap? Oh, for Pete's sake, you jerks. Now I'm all irradiated. Pea green for a while now. Okay. Nope, not grown. How dare those things not eat? Come on, guys. There's food right here. Arrgh. Oh no. You gotta be kidding me. One of those jerks turned evil. Hold on. Where is it? Is it two? Oh no. Are you kidding? They got in? This is ridiculous. This is completely ridiculous. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my god. I was that close and then this. Please tell me there's a bunch in store. There's not. Could you jerks please eat those all really fast? Okay, they died. Took out half of my earning potential, though. Oh, it's still alive. Still a lot of them alive. I think they're close to expiring now. I hope. It's all because of these jerks escaping. This is all your fault. Come on, grow! I just need a little bit more. Guess I'll scrape the remains out of that cage. Oh my gosh, 900 more. 900 more, guys! I just need a few more. Okay, it must go until 12. my gosh. I think this will do it. You guys are not eating your food. I hate you all so much. Why aren't you eating your food? Whatever. This might be enough. Wait, no. Oh my god. People. Eat your food and give me, like, 5 more rad gems. And you just die in a fire. Get back in there. I didn't say you could get out. Okay, that's gotta be enough. Okay. It's too tense for getting half the way to the best score. But whatever, we did it. With 9 seconds to spare, people. That's just how good I am. You know? Alright. Dang. Those green gems are twice as much as the phosphor. See, I guess I could have not doubled, but I could have increased my yield if I managed to get those honey slimes, but I don't think they were worth the time I wasted. I should have just doubled my farming area. I could have gotten much wider farms and grown more stuff. Oh well. I'll consider that good enough.